Everybody would please rise. Be seated. On behalf of McShann and the Winstead family, we want to say thank you today for gracing this celebration with your presence, sharing this moment with Shandy and Vance. It's said that love is a many splendored thing, that two people fall in love, get married, and they live happily ever after. But love is a gift, and we need to enjoy it as much as possible when we've been given that gift. Take it as it is. One of the best and most beautiful things that could ever happen to you is if when you find the right person. Do they make you happy? I mean, do they really make you happy? Also, do they make you a better person? Do they treat you well? Are they the first person that you want to tell about your good day or when something exciting happens? Are they the first person that you want to hug from when you've had a bad day? If love is all that it takes, why aren't more marriages stable? Why are so many marriages ending in separation and divorce? Something must be missing. As a minister, I've heard it said many times, I love them, but I can't live with them. See, there are people that we love, but we can't share our very thoughts and our feelings with them. In a marriage, we must be able to do that. John, the 15th chapter, the 13th verse says, greater love has no man than this, that someone lay down his life for his friend. Didn't say wife, didn't say husband, it said friend. It said that friend is written one letter at a time on our hearts. What that's saying is you might be able to fall in love, but it takes time to make a friend. I believe we've seen an example of that in the lives of Vance and Shandy. 9 years they've been going together, engaged for 9.5 months. Had to think about it a minute. Over the years, they've seen that they've loved each other, but it just took a while for them to learn how to become a friend. Friends that make each other happy, I mean really happy, and also make each other a better person. Friends that have learned to trust or to treat each other well. They're the first person that they want to see to tell about their good day or when something exciting happens. They're the first person they want to hug from when they after they had a bad day. And now they're the ones they want to fall asleep with and wake up next to for the rest of their lives. It's an honor not only as a minister but as the grandfather, Papa, to Shandy to be part of this celebration along with every one of you. Vance, the Bible tells us in James, the first chapter, the 17th verse, that every good and perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father. I hope that you realize that Shandy is a gift that's being given to you. The Bible tells us in three different places that you as a man will leave your family and you will be joined to your wife. And while you leave your parents, she must be received as a gift to you. So Vance, are you ready to receive Shandy as a gift from God?
Yes.
Shandy, the Bible tells us in Proverbs, the 18th chapter, the 22nd verse, whosoever finds a wife finds a good thing and obtains favor of the Lord. Realize that you are a good thing to be found in the life of Vance, a good and perfect gift from God. Because you wish to become that good thing, your home will have the favor of God upon it. Shandy, are you ready to be that good and perfect gift to Vance, that good thing in his life? Vance, would you step forward? Oh, I'm sorry. Let me refinish this. Brad. I'm trying to do the King James Version, get it done, you know, go to the I do's, get you out of the heat. The Bible says in Psalms, the 127th chapter, the 3rd verse, Brad, says, children are a gift from the Lord. They are a reward from Him. So in knowing that our children are a gift and not a possession to be hung on to, a gift to be raised and taught to love others and to serve God, a gift at some place and time to be given away. I ask then, who gives this woman to be wed to this man?
My mother and I do.
Vance, if you would take. Shandy? Good win. Shall we pray? Heavenly Father, as Vance and Shandy come here today to make this very special and once-in-a-lifetime commitment by the promise of these sacred vows, help them to never forget what they are now speaking. Grant them the desire and the will to live out these pledges that they make to each other. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Vance, do you accept Shandy as an equal to you as a person? Do you find in her the qualities that you respect, admire, and share that you believe, and share that you believe that you could live with her for a lifetime? Do you intend to give freely to her and receive freely from her? Do you receive Shandy now to be your wife, and do you promise to develop this relationship during your marriage? Shandy, do you accept Vance as an equal to you as a person? Do you find in him the qualities you respect, admire, and share that you believe that you could live a lifetime with him? Do you intend to give freely to him and receive freely from him? Do you receive Vance now to be your husband? And do you promise to develop this relationship during your marriage? You take Shandy's hands in your hand, Vance. You would repeat after me. I accept you, Shandy, as a person. And to be my wife, with your strengths and your weaknesses, to be loyal to you in health and illness, to share what I have and who I am, to love enough to risk being hurt, to trust when I misunderstand, to weep with you in sorrow, to celebrate with you in joy, and to create life with you in reverence. Let me take Vance's hand. He's holding yours. Hold his. There you go. Awesome. If you would repeat after me, Shane. I accept you, Vance, as a person. And to be my husband. With your strengths and your weaknesses. To be loyal to you in health or illness. To share what I have and who I am. Love enough to risk being hurt, to trust when I misunderstand, to weep with you in sorrow, and to celebrate with you in joy, and to create life with you in reverence. Vance, if you would take the ring and place it upon the third finger of Shandy's left hand. Shandy, the ring which Vance places on your finger is like rings fashioned many centuries ago in the form of a circle, made of precious metal, signifying the quality of your marriage as made for eternity by the hand of God. The ring has no ending, so does the love that Vance has for you today. Vance, if you would repeat after me, this ring I give you in faith, and pledge of our constant love and lasting devotion. I have the other one, please. if you would take this ring and place it upon the third finger of Francis' left hand. Vance, the ring which Shandy places on your finger is a token of her sincere love to you. The ring is gold or precious metal, at least likely to tarnish. The symbol is a value, and it is an outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace that Shandy has for you. Shandy, if you would repeat after me, this ring I give you in faith and pledge of our constant love and lasting devotion. It is said that a family is like the branches of a tree. The branches may grow in different directions, but the roots go down deep. We have branches from two different families here today that are coming together to start a new direction of their own. Vance and Shandy will plant a tree to symbolize the coming together of these two branches, putting down roots to begin not only an extension of their own families, but the beginning of their family. Understand that the Shands and the Winsteads are not losing a branch, but gaining a branch. A branch that will help bring more life and extend their tree. The tree does not end, it just gets larger. So at this time, Shandy and Vance, if you would step forward, if you would plant the soil around your tree.
Have
the wedding party to come back. They're going to take some pictures. You are welcome to, if you would, pick up your chair and take it with you back to the tables. There's chips and salsa back there for you to begin to enjoy. And we're going to be eating.
Thank you. I remember that London Everybody ready for that?
Yeah.
All right. Father, we thank you for this great day we've had today. Even as the almanac said, it's the best day of the year to get married. Thank you for that opportunity. Thank you for this couple and all the families and friends that are represented here today. Ask that you bless the food and the nourishment for our bodies. Keep everybody safe as they travel home and the honeymoon couple as they travel abroad. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Last one in has to wash dishes.
We're over there, all right. Brad, Marla, and Pat and Shannon for putting this event on. Like I said, such a special night in your life, and to have all of us included is really awesome. I think Vance and Shandy are the only couple who've been together longer than Vance and I have been together. And that's been a long time. Because we were little. So that's why me and Shandy can relate so well. We know Vance like the back of our hand. All the different nuances and things that he is. He's his own being. And we love him so much for that. But I just want to know that I really appreciate y'all always welcoming me into your life. Being there for me when life hits you. And I want you to know that I'm always going to be there for you. No matter what, going forward. So I'd like to make a cheers to Vance and Shandy, and a life full of love and everlasting happiness. Cheers.
Close friends for around 8 years now. I want to first start off by thanking Vance and Shandy's parents. They've raised such wonderful people, and I'm so happy to call them my friends. So much about their friends and family, and we all have the four of you to thank for that. Now back to Shandy. Like I said before, Shandy and I have known each other since high school. My first memory of Shandy was in our freshman high school social studies class. I sat right in front of her, and she was talking about licking people's eyeballs. And so I had to ask what in the world she was talking about. And I, being as weird as she is, let her lick my eye. We became friends very shortly after that.
That was a long time ago.
We became inseparable our senior year. We had an English college course together, and we bonded quickly over our mutual love of Halloween, Fairfoot Wide Moscato, and Shania Twain, and many other subjects. Life has taken us on many different paths. We both went to different colleges. We have never been in the same town for more than a few months at a time. But through all of that, we never lost our friendship. She's the one person that I call whenever I'm feeling scatterbrained and don't know what to do with my life. She has a way of not only telling me about everyone around her the positive side of every situation. Don't cry. here's where I might say where Vance and Shandy met. But I don't know Shandy without Vance. They've loved each other through the good and the bad. They both shine brighter, love harder, and laugh louder with each other. And they're so much better together. Here's to being better together. I love you both. Cheers.
That's great.
Wait. Hello. Thank you all for the family and friends that made this celebration as great as possible. An even bigger thank you to our wonderful parents who have made this day a journey. My name is Shelby, for those of you who don't know me. I'm Shandy's little sister. Shandy has always been an inspiration to me. She has so much pride and passion in all that she does. I'm so proud of the person that she has become and the life that she's chosen for herself, especially the man that's standing next to her to spend this life with. Vance, I have watched y'all grow for about 9 years now. I trust that you will always protect, honor, respect, and love her. 1 Peter 4:8 says, above all things, have intense and unfailing love for one another, for love covers a multitude of sins. I'm so excited to see what the future holds. God has very special plans for you, too. Let the McShanigans begin. There you are.
Hello. My name is Gwyneth. For those of you that do not know me, I'm glad to be here. I'm glad to be Shandy and Vance's flower girl. Thank you all for coming, and I'm glad you all came.
Showstopper!
That doesn't know me, I'm Shandy's dad. That's all I do know. Thank everybody for coming out. I mean, it's been the most perfect day I could ever imagine for my daughter getting married. Married a great guy. All of Sandy's life, I preached to her to make the Winstead name respectable and honorable. And now she's a McShan. You still need to make that name respectable and honorable. So Marla, we're four now, we're not five, because you are McShan. And you just do what you did with the Winstead name, and you'll be all right with the McShan name. Vance, you just love Shandy like your dad loved your mom, and like I love her mom. And I don't think y'all have any problems. There'll be days you don't like each other, but you still got to love each other. As long as you go with that, and just remember where you came from and how you were raised, then y'all be doing this in about 25 years. So, thank everybody for coming out. I mean, I know it's a perfect day for her, but it's a perfect day for me too as a dad and my first time to do this. And I can't say anymore. I didn't practice this speech. I don't practice speeches. I don't like giving speeches. But it's all about them today, and if y'all give them a big old toast, and here's to the McShans.
Thank you.
behalf of Vance and I, we just want to thank everyone for coming tonight. Whether you traveled a mile, 100 miles, 200 miles, we really appreciate the effort to be here and help us celebrate. I'm kind of like my dad. I don't practice speeches. I just kind of go with the flow. So I want to start off by saying thank you to both of our parents for helping us host a more perfect night than I could have ever imagined. Thank you for being such a great example for both of us. Our marriage will be successful because we have such great examples, and we appreciate everything that you guys have done for us. We want to thank our wedding party just for being so good looking, and also just for supporting us through the years, supporting us through our engagement, and making this day so unforgettable. We just really appreciate that. And to all of our family, just thank you for being here. Thank you for being a great example for Vance and I. We're going to kind of cut the cake, do some dances, and the dance floor is open. We're going to have a great time. We're calling it the McShanigan, so if you post anything, just hashtag us, McShanigans. We love you guys, and we hope you have a great night. Cheers.
Yeah. looking for Vance and the other McShane woman.
That was a good song.
Was Shandy and Billy Brad's kiss?
Just yesterday morning.
What?
They let me know you were gone.
Kiss isn't that good. That was a good song.
I walked out this morning and I wrote down this song. I just can't remember who to send it to. I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Won't you look down upon me, Jesus? You gotta help me make a stand. You just got to see me through another day. My body's aching and my time is at hand. I won't make it any other way. Oh, I see fire and I see rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you.
Thank you. is how we do it down in Puerto Rico. I just wanna hear you screaming, ay bendito. I can go forever cuando esté contigo. Pasito a pasito, suave suavecito, come on, baby.
Yeah, I can see your face. We can see what we need to see.
Too much.